This is a Soviet LIDA machine. It transmits low-energy radio pulses between 0 and 100 cycles per second. In the Soviet Union, LIDAs have been used for years to tranquilize psychiatric patients without physical contact. This sound, which is received by shortwave radios in the United States, is generated by another Soviet radio frequency device. It is known as the Woodpecker because of its tapping noise. It is broadcast by a number of high-powered radio transmitters operating deep in the Soviet Union since July 4, 1976. Though the official Defense Department explanation of the Woodpecker is that it is an over-the-horizon radar designed to track U.S. missile launches, some scientists suspect that the Woodpecker is designed to interfere with human brain function.
As far as I'm concerned, the potential that this has for producing a direct psychoactive effect upon the total American population is there, has never been disproven.
Dr. Robert Becker is a pioneer in the field of bioeffects of electromagnetism.
The signal range within which the Woodpecker operates is that which has been reported by many investigators to produce a tranquilizing effect upon animals.
We are just incredibly sensitive to these magnetic stimuli.
Dr. Bob Beck, a PhD in nuclear engineering, has done extensive research into electromagnetic effects on humans.
The signal was permeating power grids in the United States. It was being picked up by power lines, re-radiated. It was coming into the homes on the light circuits.
I was surprised after coming here that the influence of electromagnetic fields was almost completely ignored here.
Dr. Larissa Volonskaya was heavily involved in Soviet electromagnetic research before being allowed to emigrate to the United States. She told CNN about Soviet research in electromagnetic effects.
They demonstrated theoretically and also demonstrated experimentally that low energy electromagnetic fields also can possess biological influence, biological efficiency, because any field not only carries energy, but also carries information.
She stated that the research was carried out on orders from the Soviet government.
Of course, the military were extremely interested in this potential of remote influence.
Is the United States military working in the field of electronic mind control? Officially, the Department of Defense will not comment because the subject area is, quote, too sensitive. But CNN has learned from this government scientist, who did not want to be identified, that a Navy laboratory conducted research into the use of an RF device for counterterrorism and special operations.
It's possible to entrain a certain percentage of a population, apparently, with weak magnetic fields.
The study also showed that RF signals could dissolve certain types of rat brain cells at a distance, causing disorientation and nausea. According to the scientist, even though the program was successful, the government never followed up on it. Dr. James Frazier did electromagnetic research for the U.S. Air Force for many years. At one time, he proposed a battlefield RF weapon system.
You could make an antenna that would be carryable by a helicopter, and that this could be expected to produce a wide variety of symptoms, actually, by humans who happen to be standing in the beam.
According to Dr. Frazier, the Air Force never followed up. At Lawrence Livermore Laboratory, another RF weapons concept is nicknamed the brain bomb. According to the book Star Warriors, the brain bomb would focus a nuclear blast into a huge pulse of low-frequency RF energy that would stun huge numbers of troops. Apparently, it too has not yet been funded. The Department of Defense will not comment about Soviet RF weapons, or if American RF weapons development is going forward. However, experts interviewed by CNN say that the Soviets are apparently ahead and could exploit that lead in a surprise strategic move, a move that could have grave consequences for the United States. From Washington, this